That sensational story about Senator Robert Menendez supposedly patronizing prostitutes in the Dominican Republic seemed to unravel this week. It was days before Menendez was up for re-election when the conservative website The Daily Caller said that two women, it would not provide their names, alleged that they'd had sex with the New Jersey senator. Now, most news organizations shied away from the unsubstantiated allegations, which Menendez vehemently denied. The Washington Post this week reported on affidavits in which one prostitute said she was paid to lie about Menendez. Here's Post reporter Carol Lenig.
What we now know is that one woman, who's an escort in the Dominican Republic, and one man, a lawyer in the Dominican Republic, have gone to Dominican authorities, sought immunity from prosecution for any involvement in a smear or slander campaign, and have sworn in affidavits that they were hoodwinked into making a tape of some sort where they recited a script about having sex for money with Senator Menendez and also a wealthy donor friend of his.
The Daily Caller, standing by its story, says the paper has the wrong prostitute, which, if true, would be quite a coincidence. Here's the Daily Caller's founder and editor, Tucker Carlson, with a somewhat skeptical Bill O'Reilly.
I say the Washington Post story is ludicrous. The Washington Post story was an attempt to take down our story, but if you read it carefully, and trust me, we did, it doesn't achieve that. They hold up an affidavit in their piece as evidence that the woman we interviewed was lying. We're not mentioned in the affidavit. It has nothing to do with the story we did. And in fact, it's not at all clear that the woman they're talking about is the same woman we interviewed.
That person is pretty much protected. They're anonymous. I don't know. It makes me a little queasy, Tucker.
I get it. This is one of the basic conundrums of journalism. It's something we deal with every day.
Turns out that ABC News had interviewed the Dominican prostitutes and then did one of the hardest things in journalism. Refused to carry a juicy story because it was just too flimsy. Chief investigative reporter Brian Ross recounts what happened.
As Menendez campaigned for re-election last year, Republican operatives secretly went into overdrive to implicate him in a sex scandal.
Is that the same person you had sex with?
And they all provided the same story, almost word for word, as if they had been coached.
Now, I can't prove that the Daily Caller is wrong in saying that its reporter spoke to different prostitutes, but the FBI has found no evidence in this case, and the Caller hasn't proven that case. Based on these latest reports, it's clear that someone was out to smear Menendez and to use the media in doing so.